anybody have any questions for Mars they'd like to ask her? You don't have to, just...
Can I get a question?
So, anybody have any questions for her? Just curious.
Stand up. Here's one. This time it's going to rock down here.
What does queer mean?
Like, what does it mean to be queer?
Yeah.
Well, it's a self-identifying label. It's, you're not in the majority for your romantic or your sexual orientation or your gender identity. You call yourself queer.
That's all. Feed off what she says, as far as being called a queer, I'm a homosexual, maybe. I'm not a queer. Somebody's not going to call me a queer because I'm a homosexual male. My second question is about your coming out as far as this Straight Alliance said. Is it what county?
Barron.
What county?
Barron. How did you go about that, getting that in the school? Because here in Lowndes County, we have it at high school in the city, but the county does not. How did you as an individual do that?
Well, at my school, a lot of my teachers and administrators refuse to call me by my chosen name or use my chosen pronouns, but my peers do. And the GSA sponsored us, and within our Gay Straight Alliance, I'm fully out in the sports, and I'm very out of school, but there's still a lot of people who don't respect my identity.
So I'm just so much clear. How did you do it to get the school to buy into the program?
Oh, you're asking about the GSA, not just me.
I'm sorry.
I said I was a little, narcissistic. Well, I did research and I went to start a club. I proposed the club to the principal, and when I received no's on multiple occasions, I printed out a packet with the Federal Equal Access Act with lots of highlighter in bold, explaining why they legally had to let us have a club. And I convinced the principal that it would be a good thing, that it would support our students. So it was down to the school board. Thank you.
You talk about prejudice and discrimination in the education system. Can you talk maybe a little bit about other discrimination that you have observed or experienced either outside everyday life or media?
Okay. Well, I'm very cute, and my girlfriend's very cute. And we'll try to do, there's a scholarship for cute prom couples. We couldn't do that because one of us doesn't have a penis and identify as a boy. Sometimes it's, you know, as simple as walking down the street and when you pass a certain business, stop holding hands with your girlfriend. Oh, I'm kind of just fear. But, you know, I'm 16, haven't been on the big wide world yet, but...
What was the question? What was the question? I couldn't hear the question.
What was her succession plan? Is she the senior? Okay.
Thank you.
Well, we couldn't have an election since we just founded it, but the next president we're going to do midterm. We're going to select the next president so that while I'm still here for my last semester, we can help Randy out. I think he'll be ready.
If you were going to make one suggestion to the people in this room about something that they could do as an action that would make your life or the lives of people like you better, what would it be?
Well, I'm assuming most of you know how to use like a computer. So one really cool thing you could do is go to a place like listen.org or gaystraightalliancenetwork.com and click on like the transgender section. And look at our state. Look at what protections we have in our state. And you'll see that there are zero protections for gender identity. I could be fired if I got a job anywhere in the state of Georgia and my employer found out that I was transgender. They could fire me on the spot and not help my sucks, but, you know, you guys start somewhere, and a lot of times this can start with legislation.
Who is your answer?
My mom. She's pretty great. Has a pretty big platform, and she's never let that silence her or change her voice. So then if I want to make my voice, I have to be as genuine as she is. So I don't censor myself, I don't make my words easier to swallow because of her. Thank you.
Question?
I'm not a lawyer. That's a great question for like the ACLU or any of the wonderful people who work with me. I'm also not a mind reader. And I'm not in cahoots with a school board lawyer or anyone on the school board.
I got another question. Y'all know I was going to get out. This is why I wanted to ask this question. She wanted to ask this question. Being in South Georgia, as we all are, the stigma of HIV is positive or negative or AIDS, for example. How can we as a group, because it's not out in the community. We do have a new billboard in south side of Valdosta. It just went up, I noticed it a couple of days ago. But that's the first one I've seen in South Georgia in years. It used to be on the interstate. And that's the first one I've seen in Valdosta. It's on right there in front of the Save-A-Lots on Madison Highway. But how do we as a group get out the stigma away, because it is so, churches won't talk about it. Churches will not talk about it. But there's just many people that are HIV positive in church than anywhere else, but they won't talk about it. They won't even talk to you about it. You bring it up, it's just like run out of the room. How can we as a group change that?
Well, a lot of you guys are healthcare providers or educators or work with young people or work with
I'm people. Just here as an HIV patient. I don't have nothing to do with the health department, so I don't have that patient-client confidentiality government stuff. I can just say what I want to say. But how do we change that?
Bring it up in conversations wherever you feel safe to do so. We'll always be hypersensitive to something we never talk about.
I just want to go ahead.